What's up, guys? It's Fish here and welcome back. So today we're going to be taking a look at Ultimate General Civil War, and this may sound a little bit familiar to you guys. Basically, this is like the next iteration of Ultimate General Gettysburg, which that just focused on the battles of Gettysburg, whereas this focuses on the entire Civil War, and is actually developed by the same guy who made the Darth mods for Empire and Shogun 2. So again, if you've kind of played any of them mods and you want to carry on supporting him, please at least go check out the link in the description to the Steam page and at least have a look at this game. I also highly recommend you watch the whole of this video, because it's going to be kind of more of a review video. And then if you guys want to see more of this, then drop a like and a comment and I'll kind of continue on the campaign. So what we're going to do is we're going to load up a campaign I've already done two missions in and show you off all the really awesome campaign features. It really is an immersive experience. Like all the stuff you can do is just really cool, and I'll get onto it in a second. And then we'll go back and we'll start a new campaign and we'll do like the first mission so I can show you guys off the combat and how that works. But yeah, can I just I'll mention before we get started, I haven't had this much fun with a game in a pretty long while. The way the battles feel are really realistic. The campaign is actually like a proper, fully immersive thing. You have to manage, you know, the amount of manpower you have. You can't just spam out hundreds and hundreds of armies. You have to kind of earn them through winning battles. And, you know, if you lose battles, you get less men and the enemy get even more men. So it kind of counterweights that way. You have to buy new weapons for your soldiers, recruit more commanders to get different divisions. The battles have a supply system now. So if you have a brigade of soldiers shooting for like 10, 15 minutes, eventually they're going to run out of ammunition and you're going to have to resupply them, and if you don't, they're going to not have any bullets to shoot, which I think is really cool. But yeah, you'll see all of this as I go on. But yeah, as I said, I highly recommend you watch the entire video just to get the full idea of this game, because it is, you know, a little bit in depth and a little bit complicated on some things, but it is really awesome nonetheless. So we'll load into the campaign really quickly. This is a campaign, as I said, I've played about two missions in, and we'll run through everything in it. It might be a little bit confusing to begin with, but I'm sure once, you know, we jump into the campaign again ourselves, it'll make a bit more sense. So as I said, I wanted to show this off as well before we jump into a battle, just because it's really awesome. So at the moment, you can see I only have one mission available to me. Before this, I had another one, which was kind of like a gearing up mission. I'm not sure if this is a persistent theme in the game, but you kind of have like one historical battle which kind of progresses the main storyline, which is the first Bull Run, and then you have another mission which is kind of like a smaller one which allows you to get more money, get more men, and then, as I said, gear up for the main mission which then progresses the story. So I had to defend two supply lines, which was cool, and I had these own little forts and stuff I had to hold the enemy back at, which was awesome. So basically, how army recruitment and stuff works is I had, at the beginning of the game, to recruit a division. This is my first division, and I made each one of these units. I decided what I wanted, if I wanted guns, if I wanted cavalry, if I wanted infantry. You know, I got to make that decision. So I decided to get 3 units of 1,000 soldiers and then 1 unit of cannons. And basically, as you can see, my soldiers in the previous battle lost a large amount of men. It was a really hard fight. And I have to now actually reinforce them back up. And this is going to cost me manpower, which again, you can see up here. I get from winning battles, if we again go back to the battle map, you can see I get more men if I win the battle. Obviously, I get less if I draw it, and I get even less if I get defeated. And then the AI gets more if they win, and vice versa. So as you can see, I need to keep on consistently win battles. And if I get destroyed, it's kind of like a double-edged sword. If the AI wrecks me in a battle, I'm going to lose more men. And I'm also going to get less manpower because I just got wrecked. So yeah, you really have to work out about actually, you know, recruiting more soldiers, you know, re-establishing them. You also can buy guns if we go to the armory. So you actually have to outfit your soldiers and buy the rifles they use. You can't just buy a massive army, like you might have like 10,000 manpower and buy all these units, but you might not have enough money to actually buy all the guns they need. You have the skirmisher guns, you have cavalry, and then obviously you have the artillery. And the better artillery you have, the more expensive it's going to be. And all these stuff you do are going to affect your actual live battles, which I think is just so cool. It's such a small feature, which, you know, you buy the guns and you kind of figure out, I want the 90-second Brooklyn to have this. If we go back on the military recruitment, the army tree, you know, maybe I want the woods to have a special rifle and kind of do this special niche thing. So that's why I spend all the money on them doing that. And, you know, the same with this. And obviously you can have multiple divisions. This is actually a pretty good example of the brigade division. So I can choose to have this many men. I can say I want to have 696 men in this, and I want them to be using this rifle. To get this many men, it's going to cost me this much money.
Sure.
I'm going to apply it, and I'm going to create it. And there you go. You know, it's created it, and I'm going to be able to use these guys in battle in the future. Obviously, as I said, you've got your supply up there. If we go to the barracks, you can see your generals here. You can actually hire these guys, and the higher your generals get, the better traits they get. So as you can see, I can suddenly... Do I have, like, a proper general here, the colonel? Where do I have one? So I can assign this guy, and then you can get perks later on down the line when they're a bit higher ranked. You can actually end up getting perks. So when they, say, fight a few more battles, they can get the next level, and then they get perks to do, which will affect that unit. Again, really, really cool stuff. Sorry, I know it's a lot to take in, and I'm talking kind of fast, but I just really want to show off this game because I had a lot of fun. The next thing is the career points. Each one of these things affects the way your campaign works. So your politics influences the amount of gold and recruitments you get every single battle. So if I boosted up, 10 political points, I stick another point in that. That means I'll just be getting more men and gold every single time I fight a battle, which is pretty good, for the long run of a campaign. That's awesome. Economy obviously affects the amount everything costs, so if I wanted to go really hard on economy, my guns would be a lot cheaper, my soldiers would be cheaper. Medicine means that my men actually restore a lot quicker after battle, or I actually get more men back after battle because I've actually been able to train them up. Training means that when I want to get veteran units, which is in the army tab right here, if I wanted to make these guys... if I wanted to make these guys veterans, I do that. It's going to cost me more money, but obviously if they're really well trained and I have that training skill up, it's going to be a lot cheaper for me to do that. Army organization just means that I can have more men in a division, I believe. Yeah, I believe I can have more men in the division when I upgrade that, which is really useful. Logistics means my men have more ammunition, which is actually really important, especially in the bigger battles. You need to have your men in supply, because if they run out of guns, you're just going to get wrecked. And reconnaissance just means that you get to see, what the enemy units are using and stuff like that. So that pretty much sums up the campaign. Obviously, you just go from battle to battle, getting more men, more divisions. I imagine this is going to be absolutely massive at some point. And you'll obviously just be able to recruit more the more army organization you get. Let's go in. We'll go back to the main menu and we'll start a new campaign. And if you guys want to see me actually continue it on, then I will do. If you say get this video to like 300 plus likes, I will continue on this campaign. And jump in. So when you start the battle, you have Lincoln giving us the famous speech.
This government cannot endure permanently. Half slave and half free.
So that's always awesome. So you start off with a campaign, and it's quite a cinematic start to the campaign. It kind of sets the story. So you always dreamed on becoming a military officer like your father. It was your destiny to serve your nation in the battlefield and become a war hero. So then you move on, and this kind of feels like the Mountain Blade star, if I'm honest. It kind of has that feel to it. So you pick all of these, and the result of these, as you can see, affects your campaign stats at the beginning. So what I just ran through, army organization allows you to have more men in the division and stuff like that. So we can either be a tactician, which gives us army organization and reconnaissance, strategist, army organization and training, and or logistical. So, or we can move on to army organization and logistics. I'm probably going to go this one because, I mean, the training's pretty good, but I think there's other opportunities down the line to get the training. And I think like having reconnaissance is actually really good. So we're going to pick up, you graduated from the West Point War Academy with a specialization in tactics and learn the reconnaissance is key in preparing a flanking maneuver. So we will pick that up. Our next move is we can say what we want. We were in certain wars. So were we an artilleryman? Were we an infantryman? Were we a cavalryman? So we can get better reconnaissance. We don't really need that considering we got the previous one, the tactician, which already gave us a pretty high one. So we can say that we were a cavalry officer and took part in the Scots invasion. You were valuable in the reconnaissance and captured enemy soldiers, played a major role. We don't really want that. We can say we were an infantry officer and fought in battles. You were distinguished for your leadership and successfulness in taking the town. Or we can say we were an artillery officer participating in the northern Mexican campaign. Your skills were selected, proper positioning. So I kind of like this because logistics helps out and medicine's really important. However, I'm going to pick up the training because I didn't pick it up in the last one. And we also get another reconnaissance, which is kind of helpful. So the next one is we can say what our future career is. Are we a businessman after finishing your army career? You want to establish a company with a very successful business. So that will give us economy, meaning that stuff will be cheaper, and give us some logistics. Or we can say after the American-Mexican War, you continued your service in the army as an experienced military officer. You were appointed to a militia governor in your state. This is actually not what we did after this war, but after the previous war, you know, when we were just starting in our career. So we can say we stayed in the army, or we can say we went into politics. I'm probably going to say I went into politics, if I'm honest. Because getting the extra politics just gives you more men, and that's actually really useful, and the economy does help as well. So we can say we went into politics, and now we get the decision of who we want to fight for, the Confederates or the Union. I've seen quite a few people do the Confederates, so I'm going to stick on the Union and show you guys what that is. And then we get a decision to what we want to do, if we want to, what difficulty we want to stick it on. We can stick it on colony, which means that, you know, the enemy strength gets reduced, our reputation gets reduced, or the enemy reputation gets reduced, and their gold and recruit gets boosted. Or obviously, but vice versa, where, you know, the opposite things flip. We're just going to do it in the medium because, you know, I'm confident as a general, but we just want to push on nonetheless. So we can enter our name. We will do. We'll be Sergeant Jackie Fish, and we will march into battle. Our politics is pretty good, giving us a 7.5% income. I think that's really, really useful. We have a nice discount. It could obviously be better, but I'm okay with having it with what it is. Veteran cost 7.5%. That's okay. That's actually pretty good. Ammo, we don't get any extra, which, I mean, is a little bit scary, but that's fine. Recruitment is cheaper. Our organization isn't that great, if I'm honest, so we're definitely going to have to boost that up. I'll leave this on for right now, and our enemy information is trivial right now. So we'll start the campaign, and this will jump us into more of a kind of like a training mission to get you into the game. And I really like the way they kind of set the scene for battle. I think it's really, really cool. So General, our main objective is to secure this small town and its railroad station, which you can see marked right there. We can see that according to our scouts, the garrison should not exceed 3,000 soldiers. We must capture the town before rebel reinforcements coming via the railroad, which is right here. So we have a time limit. We have to make sure we capture the town. It is advised that you use your vanguard to clear out the town's perimeter from skirmishes or other threats. The rest of your forces are en route, will arrive southwest and assault the town. So here we go. We start off right here. We have to move forward. I have played this mission before, so I do want to be a little bit careful. And you can actually change between the views. So please let me know what one you want to see. If you'd rather see this view or more of a top-down view. So we will push on. I'm going to make my advance right here. I think I'm going to take Zook's battalion and bring it around there. It's kind of just like a click and drag to move your men. You can also right-click as well to kind of advance them. And we do actually have skirmishes up there on the hill shooting down on us. So the quicker we get over here up onto this hill, the better. It does give us some tutorial. I've kind of already read that. But basically, anything in this massive circle gets a big morale buff. And morale is really important in this game because your men can easily get broken, even if they have like 1,000 men left. So you do have to keep an eye on. It's very realistic in the way the battles work. And you can see we're getting destroyed on the flank right now. But ideally, I just want to get my skirmishes the hell out of their range and just completely avoid them, which I'm going to do. Just keep on moving, boys. We'll take Zooks up here to move round. We actually have run into some more enemy skirmishers, which we will engage. We'll take Zooks right here. We'll tell them to advance like so. Have our general move up. Unfortunately, we don't really have any cavalry to catch them. And my god, their range is still hitting me up here. Hopefully our divisions can move up. and attack. So yeah, as you can see, if we look over here to the left, we have our morale, which is currently being boosted. We have whether they're reloaded or not, which is right here. And you'll be able to see on the skirmishers when they volley. We're actually currently chasing the enemy down right now as they fall back. The scum. They're very smart tactics by the AI, shooting and falling back. We'll actually tell these guys to move around more now. I think we're out of the range of the skirmishers. So yeah, as you can see, we have their reload bar. This kind of goes up and down as they shoot, which you'll probably be able to see very soon. Like so. Then we have their cover. So, you know, but like this really affects how many men you lose in a unit. Oh, they're charging me? I didn't mean they're charging me, are they? They are, yeah. You can see the reload thing goes right there. They've decided to charge. I guess we'll charge back and just take it. We outnumber them massively. So we'll tell both our men to charge. And we'll hopefully win that. So charging is a very clear, strong tactic. Choosing this affects the enemy due to its morale buff. So basically, the melee stat really affects how melee goes. But charging head on into musket fire is a really, you know, dangerous idea because units won't just stand there. Could you imagine being told to charge into a thousand muskets shooting down at you? You wouldn't want to do it, and you have to really take a very hard look at the situation before you decide to do it personally. Luckily, I managed to get this unit to surrender because I overwhelmed it. But yeah, basically, charging units is very, very difficult on this game because, you know, your units are going to rout. I wouldn't want to charge down your entire division of musketmen. It's just going to be very dangerous indeed. So clearing out them skirmishes was good. And I'll kind of go on to more about it when we take on the men in the city a little bit later. But yeah, as I was saying, cover affects, you know, how good your you know, surroundings are, how many casualties you're going to take from each volley. If you are 100% cover, it's obviously going to, you know, make sure, you know, the enemy musket fire is going to do a lot less damage than before. And then conditioning, this is, you know, how much energy your men have. If you send them running constantly, they're going to be a lot tired, and that's going to affect their combat efficiency, especially in melee combat. Units with, you know, a really low condition aren't going to fight in melee. They're just going to run away. They're already exhausted. They're just going to get the hell out of there. So our reinforcements have arrived. Head to the town. Nice. So we've been given a unit of horses, which are going to be extremely vital. I want to move these guys up as soon as possible. We also have this unit we've surrendered. I'm not sure long-range skirmishers melee are running. So are these ours now? Can we use them to fight? I'm not quite sure how these surrendered troops work, actually. But I guess we'll find out during this battle. Move up our general all the way up here. You can see that the enemy can't see us either, and they're going to be retreating back from this position, which is a very smart move by the enemy. We'll move up our cavalry. So we've been given two more divisions. We've got the Walton division and the Loomers division. So we'll march these guys up, probably attacking. That's not how I wanted to do it. We'll probably advance these guys like up to here, and then the same with this guy up to like there as well. We have cannon as well now, which is good. So we'll set a cannon up on this hill. And then I'll probably set another cannon up on this hill in the cornfield. And then obviously we have our supply wagon. So this supply wagon helps keep our men in check. So if we look at I have to be a little bit quick right now as well. If we look at these guys, you can see they fired a few shots. So they've actually lost a bit of supply. That's like obviously their bullets. Obviously you want Zook's brigade moving up, or Zook's division moving up ASAP. So yeah, you know, you can see that we want this supply wagon actually keeps our men in supply and replenishes that stat. And it's very needed, especially for like cannon and stuff like that. It's really, really useful. So let's move up our skirmishers. It will help us scout out the enemy. We'll keep our general kind of close by, like there. Obviously want these guys like that. And obviously we have Zooks, and we have this stolen division, which I think we can use. I guess if they surrender, we can use them. I'll move them up anyway. But yeah, we have 4.5 minutes to take the town, which we will try our best to do. We can see that they have McHenry brigade in here. I think they're taking up garrison in the city, so they'll have a really high bonus because they've scouted out in the city. Basically, if you click one of these, you can actually see if it shows again. Yeah, you can see it will scatter the men out all over the city and make them like kind of just cover the city, basically get in buildings. It'll give them a really high bonus. It's basically just like they've garrisoned up the province. So our cannon is almost in position. These guys are ready. They obviously do have some skirmishes. We know they do. Just like that, please. Thank you very much. We know they have some skirmishes, so we do have to be very careful of that. We'll keep moving up Zook's brigade because we know that they are really well well trained. I guess I'll move up my cavalry as well. The cannon can actually just sit there, actually. We'll move it a little bit closer, like there. Supplies can move up as well. We've got cannons now opening up into the town. Hopefully they will start shooting. I think they're reloading right now. And we'll move up. Ideally, I want to move my scouts into the city, or at least in range. I know they have scouts of their own, so we'll keep on moving up before we attack. And we'll just attack their unit full on. As well as that, officers really make a difference. So as you can see, this unit which we captured, their officer has been wounded in action. This basically means they're a lot less effective because they don't have an officer to command them. And they won't get any of the perks we saw earlier in the campaign. We'll move on with Zook's brigade. With Zook's, we'll move that up because I want that fighting as well. And then we'll do the exact same. We want these guys to start shooting. This cannon has loaded up as well to start shooting on McHenry's. And we will advance. I want to have these guys like there and these guys like there. You guys can shoot turn there. We have Zook's moving up as well. I don't want you guys to be running. We will actually take refuge in the cornfield because that should reduce visibility. They volleyed, and as you can see, their supply went down. They are currently reloading. They fired, and they're kind of advancing and shooting, which is kind of cool. With our superior fire, we're shooting from every direction. We seem to be doing an okay job right now. The cannons are definitely helping us out. You can see we're in the cornfield right now. We have our skirmishers. We'll move up to here. Move these guys right there. The cannon is really helping us. Look at the casualties going down on their soldiers. We're obviously losing men as well. I might even bring my cavalry round here as well, just to see what they have on this right side. So yeah, let's move our cavalry round to scout. We have all our muskets shooting now. We're actually taking a bit of cannon fire ourselves, but that's okay. This unit, even though it's not in much cover, is doing okay. And look at that, we're routing the enemy forces. Perfect. I don't mind charging them down. Let's move into the city with Walton. Advance up. We'll have these guys just continue to chase them down. We'll move in Zooks as well. Because these guys do need to get a bit of replenishment, that's fine. So as you can see, they've actually formed up a defensive position along these bags. It's the same as if I did that. You can see my men would then form up here. Give them a huge cover bonus and a melee bonus as well. So if I do decide to charge that, I would obviously have to deal with that. Probably have to move our cannon up now so we can hit this. Oh, we can actually hit this, which is nice. Probably have to move this cannon up though, which we will do. Luckily, it's horse artillery, so as soon as it does mount back up, it is pretty effective. We'll move up our general as well. We are receiving a decent amount of cannon fire, though. Come on, volley! Nice, routing them back as well. I would love to chase them down, but unfortunately, I know they have some... You can actually see they have soldiers here, and I don't want to be trampled by that. So I think what we will do is we'll move up Zooks to start volleying. They do have a decent conditioning to start volleying at Laws. We have time as well before the enemy reinforcements turn up. So we'll move up our skirmishers, move our general into the town. We have the horse artillery coming in. Don't set up yet. Oh, damn. I just missed up the time. Just get in the town. Zooks. Zooks just go there. The controls do take a little bit of time to get used to. Just like move like there. I still want you guys in the town. I mean, same with like Walton's as well. I really want these guys in the town still. So let's move them there. Get a cannon set up in this hill. Obviously want to make sure I keep my artillery safe, like so. I want these cannons set up so we can bombard that position. So range attacks is affected by the equipment, weapon, the unit skill, but also the target. So if we go into I, we can actually see, you know, how good these units are, you know, what bonuses they've got from fighting, the efficiency, the command, the morale, the stamina. And this is obviously affected by the general and, you know, the other stuff. I think they're just going to retreat that unit, which is okay with me. We will continue just to try our best to pepper down this position with our cannon. And I feel like this is the way we're going to break through. We've got Walton's moving up as well. This unit is in 70% cover, I guess, because they've got some houses and some other positions as well. We'll move up our skirmishes to fight. So yeah, as I said, there's a lot to kind of take in with this, and it is kind of complicated, but I think it will make more sense as we just carry on playing. So if you want to see more of this, just drop a like and a comment. We are whittling down the Laws Brigade very, very soon. I might bring this unit back, because by the looks of it, they're moving McHenry back to the defense point, which is fine with me. We have another unit of skirmish as well. We really just need to break through this. And our men are a decent morale, so I might get these guys a little bit lower. And you can also speed up, which is nice. So if you're like, oh, this grind is taking really long, you can just stick it on the max speed and just let the soldiers fight it out. Or you can just take it slow, you know, when you're in the bigger battles, taking it slow is going to be kind of important. You can also stick it on slow-mo as well, so, you know, when the real crazy battles are going on. So we can see that they have a unit of cannons up there, which is kind of okay with me. I'm more than okay with that, actually. I'm tempted to bring up let's bring up this unit. We'll turn this unit around, we'll come through here, and then we'll break onto them. We'll give the order to charge across the bridge, and it'll be up to this division to break through. I think that's completely fair, because by the time that happens, we should be able to... we should have got these guys low enough already, because, I mean, they must be suffering. You can actually see as well, the supplies on our cannons are actually really pretty low already. You know, we haven't really been shooting too much. Let's bring up our supply wagon. We'll move this up over here to replenish these guys. And as soon as we actually get across here, well, we can actually rout them before that even happens as well. They're moving McHenry's as fast as they can to help out, but I don't know if it's gonna work. I probably should give the order to charge now, right? Let's charge. We'll give the order to charge. We'll stick it back on normal mode because we want to get across this river as quickly as possible. Yeah, we actually managed to rout them. Perfect. You guys turn. You guys go there and turn. They do have some skirmishes, and we're getting flanked. Damn, that is brutal. That charge is absolutely brutal. Form up like that, I think. We'll move up Walton's around as well. We'll continue our cannon fire as well. Yes, that's good. Try and break them skirmishes. We want to push them down. Another really cool thing about this is I can actually detach a unit. Oh, yeah, the loonies are going to break. The flanking was way too much. That was pretty brutal. Yeah, we need to kind of clear this out before we do anything else. So we will do that. Actually getting my cavalry across could be a good idea to deal with them skirmishers. And these guys are just going to fall back. They took some pretty heavy casualties, so they ran back and they will just form up again very, very soon. This is an easy push through, though. I'm pretty confident we can break this. My cavalry can hold there. I don't want to have my cavalry there too much. They do come into range of my general as well. So if they do come back, the morale is obviously going to be low. It's going to take them a while to kind of regain their morale before we can really push through. We do have our cannons shooting hard on. Our supplies are getting to these units. Let's move our supply wagon into the town. And we only have a fine iron to mount to these. We could easily run out. So let's continue to shoot McHenry's. They're down to 37% strength. They do have a ton of cover, though, which is brutal. So that's going to be reducing the casualties. I'm hoping our cannons can really kind of strike home. Our men are slightly tired. Let's try our best to move Walton's around. And we'll bring these guys into cover. And also move our cavalry around. Because if we can get our cavalry across the river to actually silence some skirmishers, that's going to reduce the morale debuff of the flanking ability. So I think that's our best shot, is move the cavalry across, try and deal with the skirmishes that way, whilst moving over a division to deal with McHenry's. We've got Law's Brigade back there. So yeah, if I have these guys, if I tell them to charge... No, charge over here, boys. I don't want to give the order quite yet. That's going to push the skirmishes back, which is all I need. It's going to be... I think they're charging in as well now. They are indeed. Perfect. That's going to slow them up. That's going to give me time to move these guys over. Move Walton's right up to here to help fight Laws. These guys to move into here. Now, it's going to break me there, but it's giving me enough time to really move up my men. The cannons can now continue to shoot at McHenry's, keep breaking them. Our cannons over here again can shoot at McHenry's. And even though we're getting flanked right now, I should probably have my general up as far as I can just to help out. I just want to get these guys so that houses cover them from the flank. Zooks can take this left flank. I'm actually going to double time them as well. And double time these guys as well. Just because I want them up here as soon as possible. Oh, some skirmishers actually come into the town. Let's be careful. I don't want to lose my supply wagon, so let's get them out. Our cavalry can actually deal with them as well. So let's just shoot them like that. You guys go and engage them. Luckily, their morale is pretty high. They've got the general there helping. Just shoot them, actually. Turn and shoot them. They have got some cannons as well. We have 2 minutes to take the town. I think we can definitely do that. We've pushed back McHenry, so let's move into the city with this unit. These guys can come across as well. We haven't lost a cannon over here, not too bad though. McHenry's is down to 200 men, whereas we still have 800 in both of our units. I believe our only strong unit left is one right here. Oh, our cannon is actually going to get routed. That's not too good for us. And I guess we'll move up our cannon over here so we can start hitting routes. We've moved into pretty much 100% cover. That's going to give us 200% cover. Nice. These guys are down to 75, whereas these guys have... What do these guys have? Will it tell me? 50 cover. So we do actually have more cover than the enemy. Yeah, just continue shooting them. We must be routing them very soon, especially over here. We are putting down the hurt right now. Our cannons are back as well, so I'm okay with that. Just shoot roots. Yeah, that brigade right there. We got our cannons rolling up as well. We'll use them to carry on shooting. We have another unit coming in. Oh, they're going to charge me. That's like a fearless move to charge me. Because I'm more than happy to take this melee. I have 800 soldiers against their 200. That's okay with me. Like, if anything, I should be the one charging them. We have now taken the city center as well. And we have to hold it for however long. It's currently contested, I think. Oh, no, we have to hold it for 17 seconds. Or just over 17 seconds, because by the looks of it, it's like a couple seconds per tick. So we have to hold this, and that'll be our objective completed. I'm going to try and just keep my men alive as much as possible, because there is actually another part of this mission as well, which we'll move on to in a second. Oh, God, yeah. God, these guys are getting destroyed. Where's our cavalry at? Go charge them. Charge down upon them. And I'll just try and do as much damage to a law as possible. I don't want these guys to fully commit onto that brigade. We do have one cannon left, right? So it must be getting low. Oh, no, this one's actually got ammunition left, which is good. But say, like, Walton. Yeah, Walton's almost out of bullets. We've only been fighting for, like, 5, 6, 7, 8 minutes. So the fact that, you know, Walton has been shooting, it just goes to show how important supplies are. And I'm actually going to charge in with this unit, even though their conditioning is a little bad. I think we're actually going to break them here. And then we'll charge on with this unit whilst this unit covers. A little cannon firing there, which is fine. Dude, our cannon is broken all the way back here. And they're going to hopefully overwhelm them. And we'll move these guys into the melee as well. It's going to exhaust them, as you can see. But the charging is just ruining how much conditioning they have. But we should just be able to overwhelm them with our superior numbers. And I'll just take this. I don't want to... They're pushing across over here. I'm okay with them pushing across. Really, all I want to do is take the town and move on to the next part of the mission. Which we are doing. So there we go. Rebels prepared to fall back. Rebels prepare for a counterattack. So we continue on. And this is kind of like the second part of this tutorial mission, where we're actually defending the town. So this is what I'm hoping the campaign will evolve into. You know, when you do a mission, the results of that mission will kind of cause another mission to occur because of it. Unfortunately, I haven't got enough into the campaign to really tell yet, but I'm hoping that's the case. So the town is secure, but the rebels are determined to retake it. We are preparing some entrenchment to stop their assault. So as you can see, all the casualties I took in the previous battle have followed on. If I was down to 100 men in each one of these units, that's how many men I would be given in this battle. And I really like that mechanic, how many casualties and how well I do in the previous battle is directly a result to the next battle. In the actual campaign, if I end up running out of manpower, I'm going to have to fight a few battles without being able to supply my infantry. And I really hope that's the case. Like, I just love this whole mechanic. And I really wish, like, Total War would kind of take more stuff like this and put it in their game. I think it's really, really cool. So the town is secure. The rebels are determined to take it, but we've prepared some defenses. So as we can see, this is where the rebels are going to be moving in for. Multiple enemy regiments are approaching from this road. The most serious threat is the armored train, which comes in from the railroad. We will have much difficulty to neutralize it without enough cannon. So hopefully we get some more cannon. And then finally, the good news is that we've got reinforcements en route, which includes strong artillery batteries. They should be arriving within the hour. Good. Good, good, good. It's going to be a hard fight, General. Ready your command. I mean, luckily, I took the previous mission without too much of an issue. You know, these soldiers did do pretty decently. They did do really, really well. I didn't really take that many casualties, which is really going to allow me just to kind of fortify this town. I think I'm going to do this part over here. Yeah, we've already seen that about the general ability. Thank you. I'm going to fall back right here into the town to kind of garrison it a bit effectively, because this is ideally what we have to hold. We have some cavalry round here. We don't really need too much, yeah, anything else. And that's everything we have right yet. We can see down in the mini-map, that's everything. We'll move the skirmishes up to the railroad. And yeah, we got this probably our weakest division defending the town. They're going to move into it. We'll have our general in the center. We have a supply wagon as well. Is everyone up to full supplies? I think they are now, right? Because Yeah, but the looks of it, the supplies move on to the next one as well. This unit's only just getting supplied now because it's in range. But before, it was actually a bit not as supplied as it could have been. This cannon right here is pretty wounded. We have a cannon right here as well. Luckily, we have a lot of men here. You can see all my men garrisoning the houses and, you know, taking up defensive formations. And we can obviously fall back at any time as well. So let's speed things up whilst we wait for the enemy to push on and try and attack us. We will hold them here with all might. I might actually deploy another unit of skirmishers. Yeah, I'm actually going to do that. Let's detach a unit of skirmishers in this unit right here. And then we'll tell them to actually get back into a defensive formation. So that's really cool. I love that ability. It reduces the amount of men you have in the unit, but you have another skirmisher unit. I really like that ability. So we'll stick these guys just across the train road. And they should hopefully help out. We have our cannon shooting. We have wheelers moving in right now. Yeah, we've already seen all of this. They're going to be moving into hopefully my archer fire very soon. We'll turn these skirmishers to kind of meet them. They're going to be moving into the cornfield, as we know. That does give them some decent bonuses. We have their own skirmish brigade moving in. The horn's charging. They're not charging me, are they? I don't think so. Our cannon's now opening up on their skirmishers, which aren't actually in range. I think these are dedicated skirmishers, whereas these guys aren't. I don't know, but the range seems a bit much. Oh, nice. Our reinforcements have arrived. That's awesome. We want these guys to move with much haste, with everything they have. We want these guys to move up. So let's tell everyone just to get up here as quickly as possible. So they should be rushing. If we can get the artillery set up, that'll be perfect. Probably get one artillery to rush like here. And then the other artillery can maybe get like across here just to shoot across the... Actually, you know, getting it in the town's probably pretty good. Pretty good indeed. I might tell them to run as well, because we do need this infantry up here as soon as possible. We have a lot of supply wagons as well. Yeah, let's tell these guys it's run to... So yeah, these guys are running now. It's going to ruin their conditioning, but they need to get up here as soon as possible. My skirmishers have been routed now. Oh my god, they've got a ton of men coming in from this right side. I'm pretty tempted to fall back already, if I'm honest. At least with Zooks to fall back. Because they have a lot of men coming at me. I need to hold for another 2 minutes. Yeah, this unit's just going to charge straight in. But I don't really know what I can do here. Because they're just going to take out these cannons until my reinforcements come, which are so far away. We've got 2nd Division. I like this as well, how you can have multiple corpses and also have divisions within the army. You know, we've got the 1st Division right here, making up of all of these guys. I really like that. By the looks of it, they're just going to be pushing on in the town. I guess I should have these guys right here, move the supplies back a little bit. I mean, Zooks can definitely break... Yeah, Zooks is going to break this formation. I might just stick these skirmishers to defend that. Because I think Zooks is, you know, 762 men's too much just to throw away like that. And you can see how hectic this is getting. And this is just the tutorial mission. Imagine what it's going to be like when we have, you know, thousands of men fighting in like the Battle of Gettysburg. Imagine how many soldiers we're going to have when we get to that. The armored train is coming in. My God, that looks absolutely awesome. Hold strong, my brave soldiers. Their cavalry is going to be trying to overwhelm my position here. And by the looks of it, they have charged in. I think I'm going to move in my cavalry to help out here. So one of my units was killed in action in Walton. As you can see, he was dead. I'm just going to remove all the perks and everything else we get. My infantry is running, though, to battle. We need to get up here to support you guys as soon as possible. My general's obviously going to fall back. On this right side, we have a pretty good formation. Our cannon, how close is our cannon? It's struggling. Can we run these guys? No, that's just limbo, so we can't run the cannon, unfortunately. But the infantry is almost across. Get across. Get across. And then get into the town. Milroy, get into the town. Please give me comments as well for what you want, because you can actually change the name. If you guys want to see more of this, let me know in the comments down below what you want me to call my units, because I'll definitely name them after. I'll leave a comment down below saying give me names for units, and it'll be up to you guys to name my units. Like, try and keep them American Civil War-y, you know, like call them the 52nd Brooklyn or something like that. But yeah, just try and keep them somewhat realistic would be cool. These skirmishes are doing nothing, so let's bring them back into the town. Walton's is obviously falling back. That's fair enough. These guys can now just march, because they need to get some energy back before they fight. So let's get one right there. We'll get Milroy right there. And then Bruce can, yeah, just come in and support. I mean, ideally, we'll get Bruce down here, because we need to make sure we defend this capture point. By the looks of it, they managed to charge me. Zooks is going to go into melee combat right now. I guess we just have to charge. They're rear flanked right now because I messed up. I clicked by mistake. But they're going to slaughter Grant. Oh my god, they slaughtered them. Can I get control of them? Oh yeah, we need to fall back. I'm actually going to tell them to run and fall back as well. They're like carry on following them, but I just want to get back. Let's turn right there. Yeah, they're going to fall back, which is, you know, sensible. Skirmish is moving up. Our divisions have now moved into the town. That's good. Walton's has managed to regain some of its energy. I think we're going to do it. We have to hold this. With the reinforcements we have, I'm feeling pretty confident. We have some cannon moving into the town. We have a cannon setting up right here. This is going to be good because they're not going to be able to hit me, but I'm going to be able to directly hit them. Our units are exhausted, though, from the sheer amount of running they had to do to get to this battle. But I think without it, we would have been very, very stuck. Zooks is back now. Good. Let's bring him in. Ideally, we want to take down this train as well. So let's focus down the train, actually, with all our cannon. The sooner we kill the train, the better, I think. Yeah, Walters has had his... Well, Walton has had his unit destroyed. These guys are marching, hopefully getting their energy back. They're just exhausted. Luckily, they're getting a morale boost. I mean, our cannon, even if our cannon's not directly hitting, we're still doing damage. So set up a cannon like there. Walton's is moving up. Nice. I feel like we've got this. I feel like we have enough infantry in the city to hold it down. And you can see the actual time of the battle ticking. And it does get dark as well. When nighttime arises, it does go dark. So that's another really cool feature I love in this game. The tank, the train is going down. It's down to 99. A few more volleys and that'll be destroyed. I think you can already see it smoking. That'll kind of reduce the amount of cannon fire they have. I wouldn't mind moving these guys up. Moving them into skirmish a bit more. The supplies. How's everyone doing supply-wise? They're okay. I don't want you charging. I just want you shooting. Supply-wise, our cannon is doing okay for supply. I think the supply is actually in range of all of these guys. Good, good, good. Continue to shoot down the train. Yeah, everyone's okay for supplies right now. We also have another supply truck coming in, which we'll stick in right here. Yeah, we'll stick these guys in this town just to give them a bit more cover. Ah, it's retreating. Perfect. Get the hell out of here, you scum. Continue to take it down. They're actually charging me as well, so let's move Bruce up. They're charging the town, trying to overthrow it. My men do get a melee bonus, though, because they are actually in the town, you know, fortifying it. They're going to take in a few of my other units as well. But we have two against one there. As the train tries to get out of there, we might destroy it. We do still have a cannon right here, which we'll be able to shoot it as it runs away. I think this is just about to come out of range of this cannon. Well, I think we're going to destroy it, which is awesome. Send the Confederate scum back to whence they came. Come on, shoot it. Take it down. Take it down. Oh, it's so close. No, I think we can... Yes, we destroyed it. That's a good moral victory for me. I'm happy with that. Very happy with destroying that. Let's push on. I think this supply point right here... one of our units surrendered. So, yeah, how does this work? You manage to capture an enemy unit. It advised to select it and press the withdraw button to send it out of the map to read more surrender. I'm actually tempted to do this if the guide works. Obviously, the game is in early access right now, as the title said. I don't think I actually remember that. So can you actually withdraw units as well? Nice, that's actually really cool. So if you feel like a unit's had too much and you want to maybe save it, you can actually withdraw from the battlefield. I didn't actually see that, and that's really cool. I'm really happy we destroyed the thing, though. Let's push them back, then. Move up our skirmishes right there. Our cannons are... yeah, I think this is a supply point, and if we hold it, our unit stays supplied. That's cool. That kind of means that you've stockpiled supplies. I really... there's just so many features. Again, I'm learning about the game, and I think are just really, really cool. So let's move up. Let's move up a unit over here. We'll take refuge over there. Overwalking over where our previous cannon position was. This unit's withdrawing. Yeah, this is the one we captured. Walton has had a hard fight, but we're pushing the Confederates back now. They obviously have some cannon over here as well. I mean, we'll send these guys to go deal with them, along with them. Cannon can still pin them down. Oh my god, they're charging. I mean, they just look at their numbers. They lost so many men on that charge. And I get a bonus in the charge as well. And I guess you guys just charge in as well. You're pretty exhausted and you're getting flanked by their missile fire there, but that's fine. I don't think they're going to come out on top in this engagement. They're withdrawing, which is fine. We'll move up our general as well. This is something I should have already, just to keep on giving me a morale buff, because Zooks maybe would not have routed. But we'll continue on our push, pushing scales back as well. Move up our skirmishers. Yeah, I want to make them bleed. Because obviously, the more men they lose in this battle as well, the more they'll lose in the campaign. So the next battles will be easier because they're losing men. I'm pretty sure that's how the AI works in this. You know, the more men they lose, the more men... I need to turn as well over here. Yeah, turn. The more men they lose, like, in the battles, it carries on much like it does me as well. That's why I would really, really love a co-op campaign. Or, like, not a co-op campaign, but an actual campaign. Imagine playing against this with the whole way the campaign map works, battles, how soldiers take over, you know. Imagine that, but playing against someone. That would be fucking amazing. Imagine me and Apollo doing that. That would be so much fun. So much fun. And I think it's only a matter of time until we break them here. Yeah, look at that. Another unit down so we can advance right there. These guys are exhausted, though. Fuck. They did have to run here, which is, again, a really nice kind of balance you have to find. Do I rush to defend the city as fast as I can, which will mean my men are exhausted, or do I walk a bit so when my men get there, they actually are ready to fight and they're not, you know, completely dead? I really like that exchange. We managed to route this unit off the field. We move our skirmishers around to take out their cannon. But yeah, I think this is going to be a pretty good victory for me as we move on. Walton's has a bit more energy, so we're going to be kind of slow on these guys. But yeah, by the looks of it, we've completely routed the enemy. They're withdrawing from the battlefield. I'm actually going to charge the cannon with my skirmishers, because obviously that's the best way to get it out. It depends if we get grape-shotted in time. They are charging. Yeah, we already know that. You've told me that. Cool, nice. We managed to silence the cannons, which is good. So let's advance our guys over the train. Again, I think these guys were taking a bit of energy back, getting a bit of rest. But yeah, the town has been saved. We took it, and I think with pretty good casualties as well. We didn't really suffer too many casualties, which I'm pretty happy with. So we'll speed things up now. I'm pretty sure we're going to win the battle. We just have to wait till the timer runs out. And we'll just move through a few lines of infantry as well. It's just a few units of skirmishers left. Probably want to kill the infantry first. They have a few more units moving in. We'll try and rush up to this defensive position right here. Yeah, we overrun the cannons right there. But yeah, I just can't wait. Like, if you guys want to see it, we get to a point where we're commanding hundreds of units. Like, well, not hundreds. I'm not sure if the game runs hundreds, but you know, when we're controlling a massive battlefield going all down here as just units, and we have reserve units so that my infantry can, you know, if they do rout, I can fill in the gap with another unit. I think that's just really, really cool. We're gonna be fighting. Then we do have cannon support as well, which is nice. We have some cannon support over here. And again, something I didn't mention as well, you can actually see, so the battle has been finished. I just want to mention this quickly. Something I didn't mention is you can actually see how many units the people killed as well. So you can see that the Bruce killed 345 and only lost 51. So you can really see like these famous last stands, you know, of units and stuff who actually rack up loads of kills. You know, the unit that managed to hold the left flank, you know, Zooks has killed 600, but they've also lost 400. You can really see what units have gone in, and they'll obviously get better and better the more they fight. So there we go, we'll finish it. We'll get this victory. We capture the train station on the 1st of July, or 1st of June, sorry. We can see who deployed what. I deployed 5,500. The Confederacy deployed 7,500. A bit more cavalry and a bit less guns. I had more guns, which was good. Then we look at casualties. I lost 2,000 men and they lost 4,000 men, so definitely in my favor. We also took a few more guns compared to how many they brought as well. I lost a lot of cavalry, and they also have 556 men missing after we routed them. You can look at the units to see who killed the most, which is nice. I like that. And you can also just go to like the Just for Union, Just for Confederacy to see how many they got and stuff like that. Also, you see the goods. I guess you captured and you rescued certain guns as well and supplies. And obviously also see what officers have been promoted. And this will, you know, see who died, who got wounded. And then this will allow you to actually get more traits and stuff, which we can take another look at. So I got the Civil War Campaign Medal. That's good. Oh, crap. I didn't see what else it gave me, unfortunately. That's unfortunate. But you can see one of my guys is leveled up and he's actually got the Discipline Training. So his Looms Brigade, again, as you can see, all these guys have followed on from the previous battle. As you can see, his men will now have 10% more morale and they'll be better because of his commander. However, if I lose this commander, then that's going to severely fuck me because I'm going to have to put a new fresh commander in here. And as Napoleon says, I think the quote goes, which I'm going to butcher, 100 lions led by sheep are going to die, but 100 sheep led by one lion are going to be victorious. It's something along them lines. I know I butchered it, whatever. But yeah, it's really cool. So yeah, that's going to be the overall of the game. There's a few other things you can see. You can check your supplies for your supply wagons. You can increase that. And that's going to cost you more money, the more ammunition you want to take to a battle. Obviously, I can now recruit more men. So because I've only got my army organization, which we have to go to the... armory? No, it's career. So we got a career point as well. So because our army organization is only one, I have to spend another point, which I'm going to do because I want to boost that up.
Yes, sir.
That's going to allow us to recruit another unit over here, which we can do, and we get the choice of what to do it. I'm probably going to get another unit of infantry. We'll get 1,000 soldiers. We'll give them... I don't really see... I think that these are a bit better... in melee, maybe? It's kind of hard to tell. I wish they would give you more advice. I guess it does show you right here. And you can compare the two like so. I mean, it's this is what they currently have. So you can see their effective ranges, you know, their fire rate. I think these are very similar, actually. These have a bit better in melee. And they're a little bit better accurate. So I could do that. That'd cost me a bit more money to buy them. You know, 13,000 to give me these soldiers a rifle each.
Yes, sir.
Which we will do. So it's going to cost me this much money and this many men. So you can see from the top, it's going to take away from that and go in. And this is the new division. You can rename all of these. You can rename the division names and stuff like that. So, yeah, that's been Ultimate General Civil War. Hopefully, you guys understood everything I was talking about. I was kind of, you know, really excited and stuff like that. So I did talk a bit fast, which I do apologize for. Hopefully, it wasn't too bad. As well as that, it's kind of a lot to take in. There's a lot of stuff you have to really keep an eye on and think about and, you know, to look at. But it's really, really cool. Really awesome. So if you guys want me to move on to like the next campaign mission, which is going to be this one, which is the distress call. Again, you can see these are kind of like the minor missions by the looks of it. They don't have that reef around it and you kind of get a little bit less men from the battles and stuff like that. Then, then just let me know in the comments down below by liking this. You can also use your reputation as well. I'm not sure if it allows me to actually click it here. You can actually use your reputation to get commissions from the government. So as you can go, I can click this government symbol right here. And if I want to spend 5 of my reputation, or 8, I think I have 8 to spend. I can spend 8 of my reputation and then they'll give me 2,000 government issue rifles. Or some more 10 pounders or a new general, you know. These generals are really, really good. which is cool. So yeah, that's been Ultimate Generals. Hopefully I've explained it well. I think the more campaign parts I do, the game will make a lot more sense and be more interesting. So let me know in the comments if you want to see more of this. And as I said, give me names, go over and check this game out. It's been Fish, and I'll see you guys next time.